Why some of your warriors are you going to be on your best behavior?
One of the senior superlatives this year is best laugh.
Kale.
Yeah, that's good.
And Katie Wagner. Kate Wagner, excuse me, for a girl. If we did superlatives on the faculty, best laugh would have to go to this year.
Have you ever heard of one?
Oh my gosh.
You ever hear a funny joke?
Every time I hear her laugh, it just makes me giggle.
Okay, I have a joke for you. Don't move it from yourself.
Senora's is funny because she remembers the last stuff.
Okay. What is a whale's favorite game?
What?
Swallow the leader.
What?
Now.
What do you call a cow with a twitch? Beef jerky.
Isn't that funny?
Yeah.
Twitch
jerk.
Yeah.
I like that. I like that a lot.
Okay.
No more jokes.
No. We gotta work. Okay.
More jokes.
Shh. Listen. The amount of a product that should be obtained when you're doing a reaction. Okay. The amount of product that should be obtained in a reaction is called the theoretical yield. It is determined by stoichiometry. If I say to you, you start a reaction with 27 grams of oxygen, how much water do you get? And you do the problem and you set it up and you say, I get 84 grams of water. You just do stoichiometry and you get that answer, which we've done all week. That is the theoretical yield.
We've already done it. Good, move on.
I said to you at the beginning of the block, remember, I said, we're going to talk about theoretical yield, and we're going to talk about percent yield, and really, theoretical yield, you already know it. You do already know it. Have we called it theoretical yield until this moment? No. But that's what it is. Yes? What that means is, if you do the chemistry, if you put this amount of this together with this amount of this, and they go together, and nothing is lost or gained, perfect chemistry occurs. When you do the stoichiometry and you numerically determine that you're going to get this many grams of this, if perfect chemistry happens, that's how many grams you get. Now, it happens all the time in chemistry that you make a gas and some of the gas escapes. It happens all the time in chemistry you put things together and they pop and fizz. And things like fly off. Like, oh, it now it's stuck to the ceiling, and so if you try to put it on the scale, you can't measure it, correct? You understand what I'm saying?
Not scrape at all.
It also happens a lot of times when we do chemistry that water vapor from the air is picked up and taken into the product. So then when you take that little beaker and you put it on the scale, it's supposed to be 27.4, and it's 28.9. It happens all the time, okay? If you're doing a reaction where you're supposed to get all of the water gone, like you're supposed to heat it up until it's totally dry, and that doesn't quite happen, it ends up heavier than it's supposed to. Perfect chemistry doesn't happen all the time. Theoretical yield is perfect chemistry. Theoretical yield is what you should get based on the math. Period. Okay? Now, we are going to do this problem. You don't necessarily have to look it up in the book. I'm going to write it for you. We're going to do this problem, and we're going to look at percent yield at the same time. Now, let's go ahead and talk about percent yield, and then we'll sort of come back, okay?
All right, so this is basically percent error?
Sort of.
So we want it to be high on this one. So we wanted to calculate our percent error when it came to this. We'd have to do measured minus accepted divided by accepted times 100.
But the measured and the accepted. Measured is another way to say actual, and accepted is another way to say theory.
That's lit.
If you go in the lab and you're supposed to do chemistry and create 50 grams of sodium chloride, if you go in the lab and you create 50 grams of sodium chloride, your percent yield is going to be 100. You've got 100% of what you're supposed to get. If you took that information and you said the measured is 50, the accepted is 50,
divided by
50 times 100, you would have 0% error, 100% yield. So you want percent error, which is percent wrongness, to be low,
and percent rightness percent to be high.
Yield, which is percent rightness, to be high. Now, remind me, because it's been a while since we talked about it, percent error is measure minus accepted divided by accepted times 100, and what is our threshold? Good percent error is where? No, between
0
and 10. Remember, we said if your percent error is over 10, that's really not acceptable. Now think. What then would be acceptable in general for percent yield?
90
to
100.
100 is perfect. You allow 10%, okay? Now, could you have a percent yield that is higher? Could you get more than you were supposed to?
Yeah.
Yes? If that happens, then the threshold would be 100 to what? 110. If that's the case, then your percent error is one of those percent errors that comes out negative. Holy cow. Yes?
Kaboom.
Okay.
My mind has been blown.
Now, here's what we're going to do. Okay? We're going to practice percent yield by looking at theoretical yield sort of at the same time. And I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. Okay?
We've done so many theoretical yield problems already.
I know, but we got to take it one step further. All right? So I'm going back to 406, number 30. Y'all don't have to write that down or turn your book. I'm going to write it on the screen. All right. We've seen this a couple times.
No.
Thank you.
So do we have to do stoichiometry to do this?
Yep.
Call back because we have to get the theoretical yield, and then we got to do the percent yield.
So, percent yield.
That's pretty easy.
What's the equation for percent yield? We just learned it. What is it?
Actual
divided by a theoretical times 100. The actual is gotten where? I said that in your notes. In the lab. So this is what Johnny got. Okay, so we know right now that the top of this equation is 53.64. That's what he did in the lab. Where did I say the theoretical came from?
Stoichiometry.
Yes? Okay, so we got to figure this out. The bottom. Capiche? Okay, I've got to erase the screen because I wrote too big. Are you guys okay? All right, 84.8 grams. Y'all have to tell me what I said because I've already forgotten. I mean, I'll forget. Grams of what?
Iron oxide.
Fe2O3. And we're trying to find, I said what? How many grams of iron? How much iron? Is that what we said? Well, we know that Johnny got however much iron.
Yeah.
Okay, so we got to figure out the theoretical iron. Yes? Okay, look. We need the value of the question mark for iron oxide. We need the value of the question mark for iron in order to do this stoichiometry.
Yeah.
Iron is super easy. 55.85. That's grams per mole. That's easy peasy. Okay. Fe2O3, two Fe's plus three O's. Somebody give me that.
159.7.
Is that what y'all have?
Come back, papers. Oh, no, drop papers. Oh,
okay. Now, starting here. Three conversion factor. Gram, gram, stoichiometry. We said for Fe2O3, it was 159.70 grams. This is 159, sorry. Smart board's dumb. This is always opposite one mole. Guys, we're going till the bell rings today, so please don't anybody pack up, even if you get finished with the problem. We need the mole ratio from the balanced equation, moles of Fe2O3 as compared to moles of iron, because we care about what is Johnny's iron percent yield. Fe2O3 balanced equation has a 1 in front of it. Iron in the balanced equation has a 2 in front of it. Now I got to get into grams of iron. If I'm using question mark grams, it's always opposite one mole. So I need one mole on the bottom of the conversion factor. Thank you. What's my math? 50.
59.3.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so what is this then?
That's just the geometry. That's the theoretical.
This is the theoretical yield. Alright, so what did I tell you when I first wrote the problem? I've erased it, so I really don't know. What's the actual yield? What did Johnny get?
53.64.
Alright, so he got 53.64. That's the actual. We divide that by the theoretical. Please listen to my words. The 53.64 was grams. Everybody look. Some kids in third block and some of you guys are still doing this. We're 6 days away from the SOL test. And when I ask you to calculate a percentage, you give me a number of grams percent. Or a number of grams per milliliter percent. Or a number of moles percent. What is that?
Wrong.
But, like, after you write it down, look at it and say, like, y'all been doing percent since elementary school. It's a number percent. Yes? Okay? And what is our rule for percentages? Two places past the decimal. We don't do sig figs on this. It's a percent, two places past the decimal. So what is our answer here? What is his percent yield?
90.46%.
Kicks and giggles.
Okay, here's what it's going to be like. 9.54. Guarantee it. If it is, you owe me a cup of those M&M's.
Somebody do that math.
If it is, I get a cup of M&M's.
Somebody do that math. What is this?
Percent.
Yes, what is this?
Measured
minus... Accepted. Bye bye.
9.54. Cup of M&M's is mine.
Do you appreciate? Okay. So that is what? 9.54. What's the unit?
Percent.
This is yield. This is error. Could you? After calculating percent yield, could you then take those numbers, plug it into percent error, and if you got the opposite number, it might be
you
a way to double
right.
check?
You know you're right.
Yes?
I love chemistry.
Especially yes?
Especially M&Ms that we get because we're in chemistry.
All right, you have homework. What?
She suddenly hates chemistry.
Right here. That's it.
It's the weekend. I have plans.
It's three problems.
Hello? Okay, hold on.